Hi everyone and welcome. My name is Angelica and I am an artist from Sweden that likes to play around with watercolors, as you will see in this video. So I bet that I am not the only one that sometimes get an idea stuck in my head for quite a while before I actually do something about it. And so was it with these two paintings that you will see come to life. I had wanted to paint an alpaca in like almost a year, and then I start to think about painting one in bright colors. I have been a hand spinner for many years now, and I like to dye the wool in different colors. Or with alpacas, I think you say fiber instead of wool, but I say wool for like everything. Not only sheep wool, but angora wool and so on. And yeah, I like to dye them in bright colors, and Then I start to think how an animal would look with the wool already in bright colors when it is on the animal. And I would not like to dye an real animal to see that. But because I am an artist, I can use my imagination and just paint it. So that's how these two paintings started to become to life. So, and my goal was to get them quite realistic, which is mostly always my goal with my paintings. I want to make them as realistic as possible. And for this first one, I did get it quite realistic. Not as much as I wanted to, but this is the best of the two ones. As you can see here, it looks quite good. Self-bragging, that's always a good thing. But yeah, and I did not spend so much time on either of those two paintings. I had recently, before I made those two, I had put down very big amount of time with a realistic dog. And often when I have done a painting that took a lot of time and energy, I like to do an easy painting that I can be done with in 3 or 4 hours, just to keep my creativity flowing and not get drained out of my creative use, if you can say so. And with the first painting, I got quite bright colors, and then I wanted to do one with more pastel-like colors, so therefore I did the second one. And this one was harder to get realistic, and I don't know if it was that I used all the colors everywhere on it, because with the first one I used the colors in different sections. And here I just have to try to have the colors bright and not get them muddy. So that was a little bit of a challenge. And also with, I don't know if nose is the correct word, but I will just say nose and mouth of this second one I had difficulties with. I had difficulties with the first one also, but the second one was harder. So, but I like to challenge myself, and I always feel that I getting more experienced and get better paint skills after every painting, so that's a good thing. So here is the second one, all finished up. And for the highlights and for getting some parts more lighter, I used some white gouache for that. Also with the first one, I used some gouache for the lighter parts and make highlights. So here you see the two finished piece side by side. And I mainly used four different colors for creating those two paintings. I used Schmincke Horadam Quinacridone Purple, Mission Gold, Quinacridone Permanent Magenta, Daniel Smith Phthalo Blue in Green Shade, and Winsor & Newton Professional Aqua Green. So those four colors and from four different brands are the main colors in those paintings. And I also used some gray and black, and as I said, white gouache from Winsor & Newton. And mostly one silver black velvet brush, as you can see I did put down there in around in size 2. So I hope you have enjoyed this video and me rambling about those two paintings. So I hope you are having a great day or night or whatever time you are having wherever you are. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the like button, and I will be very thankful to that. So, bye-bye.